So, you see two images here. The left one is the photo, and the right one is the painting where the folds have been painted. So, we'll be doing a demo of doing this painting and a bit of color wheel theory here to let audience know how the selection of tone or the color is made for the folds. So this is the base color, which is cadmium red, or you can call it quinacridone red, or we can say vermilion. So this is the base color of the robe. And the theory is that when you want to do the shadows, which is the fold, you have to go few tones lower, darker. So in this case, this is the darker tone, which is the next tertiary color. But since it's a watercolor and since these are transparent, we will go one stage lower because of transparency. This also will show up the base color. If it was acrylic or oil, one could have, or digital art, one could have straight gone for this, but we will go for this. Similarly, for highlights, of course, we will not be doing demo of highlights. One is to go a tone lighter here. In case of watercolor, one more tone lighter. Now this is the photo. And I have drawn an outline here. And after drawing the outline, you do the outline of the folds with pencil. And the next step is on the sketch, which has the penciled robe marks, you do the top color of the robe and the bottom color of the robe. I have purposely taken lighter than what is in the photo just to demonstrate, because otherwise the folds will not be visible in this demo. Now, I will, for the sake of saving time, take you through a 10-minute video because it was not possible to finish a live demo in 15 minutes. And this video I took just yesterday. So here we start. And after this demo ends, we will have the question answer session. So as you can see on the right, you have the.
So friends, this is the reference photograph, and this is the pre-painted base colored painting with the red on the top and magenta in the bottom. For the red one, we will use magenta color for the folds. And for the magenta base, we will use purple color for the folds. So we start with the red one. We use a thin brush and a very pasty consistency of the paint, as otherwise a dilute paint will spread out on the painting. So here we go. And with a damp brush, not wet brush, we'll smoothen out the edges to remove the hardness.
For shadows, it is necessary to smooth out the edges. Otherwise, it will look very hard. sometimes the smoothing has to be done on both sides of the shadow. And as you can see, I'm not pre-wetting the base. I'm working on dry surface and using a pasty consistency paint. And spreading it with the wet brush, with the damp brush. I'm making it darker.
So this was just to illustrate the folds on the red part. Now we'll do the bottom part with purple color. We'll not complete the project because there is not enough time. We'll leave a few minutes for question answer session. Now I'm using the purple color for the magenta bottom part. Again, we are softening with a damp brush.
Softening the edges is one of the critical factors for painting shadows.
So friends, this is just a short demonstration of a few folds. If we had to do all the folds, it will take a little longer. So we'll now take up questions and answers. Thank you.
So friends, if there are questions, I'll be happy to answer those.
Hi Vijay, I can see one question which is by Karishma. Karishma asks, is the base color dry or is it still wet?
Dry.
Okay. And if anybody has
Let me add here that different watercolorists have different techniques. And I'm sure there will be some who will say that this is the way we do the shadows. And it's quite possible that they will also get good results. But this is a technique I adopt, which has been working quite well. And I have done several paintings using this, which have come out quite well.
Okay, here is one more question by Nandita, if you can read, Vijay.
From Neelima.
Nandita asks,
paper, I use Arches 300 GSM cold pressed paper, but that's not the issue. You can use any good quality watercolor paper, and the color can be of any brand. Use the artist grade, not the student grade. And don't use Cotman of Winsor Newton, because that's a lower grade than their professional grade. So any brand is okay. Only one tone darker for shadow and one tone lighter for highlight. And since it is watercolor, we'll go two tones darker because the lower base also shows up, and two tones lighter for the highlight. Okay, Karishma is asking what color, what brands of watercolor. Well, I use Camlin a lot, but I also use Winsor Newton, Holbein, Rembrandt, American Journey. But that's not very important. If you want to make shadow, this is from Siddharth, if you want to make shadow softer at a later time, is there a way to do it? Yes, you can lift off the color with a damp brush skillfully. From Neelima, there is a question. Is it okay if the paper is not 100% cotton? Well, 100% cotton gives you a couple of advantages. One is it can take abuse more. You can lift off. That's one advantage. Then second advantage is if you use masking fluids, then it retains. The paper is not disturbed. And the biggest advantage of 100% cotton is that it's an archive quality. So it will last you a couple of 100 years. Without aging. So 100% cotton papers are expensive. Arches is definitely 100% cotton, but many other brands are not. So if you want longevity of your paintings, use 100% cotton.
So I think, Vijay, we have the questions done. We also have now another session, which is going to start shortly. Thank you so much, Vijay, for being with us and demonstrating. Everybody who's listening, Vijay is also exhibiting in this art fair, and you can find him at his Instagram, which is @VijayKiawar. There was a question which came about Vijay's Insta handle, so that's his handle. Everybody have a good day. It's the last day of the fair, so I hope you all have a very nice day ahead. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thanks for watching, and if you visit my booth, I'll be in the booth in a few minutes. We can discuss whatever you wish to discuss further regarding this. Anything
I'll
else about
just
watercolor?
Add one thing over here. If you can't find Vijay in his booth, because there's only provision for one person to be at the booth, so you can always drop him a message. There's a message icon. You can just click on it and drop him a message as well.
So thanks to the audience and Gunjan for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vijay sir. It's always so nice to see you. We'll take the exit now. Thank you.
Okay.